Back from the first EU-CELAC, Community of Latin American and Caribbean States Summit in Chile, the President of the European Commission, José Manuel Barroso, joined the European Parliament in Brussels on the occasion of the European Parliamentary Week event devoted to the European semester. Speaking at the opening session, President Barroso emphasized the social challenges the European Union is still facing.
It is clear that we must take even stronger measures to fight unemployment, notably youth unemployment, and I'm confident that this is going to happen. I believe that we are still on time to address the issue of youth unemployment in the discussion for the next multi-financial framework. Those speculating against the euro earlier have underestimated the political capital that is invested in it. Let us continue to prove them wrong and be aware not to disinvest at such a crucial moment, just when our investment is starting, and I underline starting, to pay off. A lot still has to be done. Stabilization is not a recovery. We may have calmed unrest among markets. We have yet to raise hope among citizens.
President Barroso pushed again for a strong EU multi-annual budget, or MFF, that's essential for investments supporting growth, competitiveness and job creation. He emphasized that the European budget offers a European dimension to economic growth, infrastructure and research, even for the strongest member states.
I cannot see how some governments that are speaking about the need to support growth, rightly so, and to support competitiveness, rightly so, when it comes to the discussion of the most important instrument we have at European level to promote investment, the answer is not so clear.
Warming up for the debate at the European Council at the end of next week, the President multiplied political contacts with several heads of state or government. Meeting with Italian Prime Minister Mario Monti in Brussels, he underlined that the MFF is very much a part of Europe's overall strategy to deal with the economic crisis and an important tool for investment, for growth and jobs, and for solidarity for the next 7 years. He also stressed that any agreement among member states would require the consent of the European Parliament. President Barroso also met with Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orbán. They discussed the agenda of the upcoming European Council, as well as the recent developments in relations between the European Commission and Hungary. The President particularly commended the Hungarian authorities for their swift response to the judgment of the European Court of Justice on the retirement age of Hungarian judges. The new draft bill has been submitted to the Commission within the agreed time frame and is now being analysed. The President said that he was confident, thanks to close collaboration throughout the process, that the legal case could be closed in the near future. President Barroso also held talks with the newly appointed Lithuanian Prime Minister Algirdas Butkevičius. Apart from the upcoming European Council and the negotiations of the EU multi-annual budget, they also discussed Lithuania's announced ambition to adopt the euro in 2015. Finally, still on Wednesday, President Barroso received Somali President Hassan Sheikh Mohamed. The two leaders discussed the country's path to a stable political future. The EU is already the largest donor in Somalia, having mobilized over €500 million in development aid since 2008 and €60 million in humanitarian assistance this year alone. The European support has focused on three key areas in Somali development over the past 3 years: defense, diplomacy, and development. Last week, the European foreign ministers agreed to extend an EU mission to train soldiers in Somalia, which has succeeded in training some 3,000 Somali troops since 2010, for another 2 years. The mandate of the EU's anti-piracy mission off the Somali coast, EU NAVFOR, has also been extended until December 2014. On Thursday, the President travelled to Vienna, where he met with Austrian Federal Chancellor Werner Faymann. They agreed that the future European multi-annual budget must address the current major social challenges. In a statement after the meeting, President Barroso pleaded in favour of stepping up the fight against youth unemployment, which is a serious concern to him. Answering questions by journalists after the meeting, President Barroso specified that he will insist that the future budget allows for a new instrument dedicated to the fight against youth unemployment. While in Vienna, the President also participated in the opening of the Sustainable Energy Conference, R20, launched by the former Californian governor and actor Arnold Schwarzenegger. He praised the R20 initiative that intends to focus on the role of states, regions, cities and provinces in working to achieve the UN and EU environmental goals as a shining example of innovative cooperation that's crucial to achieve these goals. In his speech, President Barroso said that energy plays an essential role in development and global growth, and thus must be the heart of all European policies in the years to come. He also strongly defended the EU stance for sustainability, saying that it's now deeply ingrained in all EU policies, and reiterated the EU's commitments in terms of greenhouse gas emissions, renewables, and energy efficiency, as charted in the Europe 2020 strategy.